there, me hearties, and welcome back to the Pirate's Poetry Corner and General Thing and Spot Her. Today we'll be reading a poem by Eugene O'Neill entitled Free. Weary am I of the tumult, sick of the staring crowd, pining for wild sea places where the soul may think aloud. Well, I understand that feeling, you know. I've been there, you know. I can tell you. Sitting around in a group of people, you know, the people that are landlubbers. Landlubbers, you know. You gotta stay away from the landlubbers. My hearties, I tell you, landlubbers, they're like zombies. And that's all you get from them. Anyway, so I'll go back to the beginning here. But, you know, I just have to say, too, where the soul may think aloud. You can think aloud anytime you want. You know, Eugene, come on. It works for the rest of us. Some people may think you're a little bit off your nut. But you know what? Maybe they're right and maybe they're wrong. Who am I to say? Right, so here we go. I'll start it again. Because I don't wish to digress from the poem. So we'll start again. Weary am I of the tumult, sick of the staring crowd, pining for wild sea places where the soul may think aloud. Fled is the glamour of cities, dead as the ghost of a dream. When I pine anew for the tint of blue on the breast of the old Gulf Stream. Now, shipmates, I think when he says Gulf Stream here, I think he's talking about the currents in the Atlantic Ocean. I don't think he's talking about the type of private jet. You know, so anyway, we'll continue with the poem. I have had my dance with folly, nor do I shirk the blame. I have sipped the so-called wine of life and paid the price of shame. So what he's saying is he's done the things that people all said he should do. He should go to the city, and he did it all on his own. He went to the city, he had the whole high life, la, 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 la. He did all that stuff, and now it's cost him a bit. And we'll continue. But I know that I shall find surcease, the rest my spirit craves, where the rainbows play in the flying spray, mid the keen salt kiss of the waves. Hey, that's a great image, isn't it? You know, what is he saying? He's saying, I go to the city, and I've lived the life, you know, the whole jet setter kind of a thing. I'm probably not a jet setter, even though it was a Gulf Stream. It's not the plane. Anyway, he's lived the high life, as it were. And now he realizes that really, the place where he finds rest, the place where he finds his surcease, is the place by the sea. Or even on the sea. We'll continue. Then it's ho from the plunge and deck of a bark. It's a bark, you know, the ship. We're not talking about, you know, the outside of a tree. The stuff that grows on the outside is kind of prickly and stuff. We're not talking about that kind of a bark. It's a ship. A sailing vessel. Here we go. Then it's ho from the plunge and deck of a bark. The hoarse song of the crew. Because, you know, when they've been singing a long time, they kind of get scratchy in the voice. Anyway. With never a thought of those we left, or what we are going to do. Nor heed the old ship's burning, but break the shackles of care, and at last be free on the open sea, with the trade wind in our hair. Hair. Sounds like he's going on the account, doesn't it? Sounds to me like old Eugene O'Neill wants to be a pirate. Go out on the sea, free from the shackles of city life. And, you know, don't have to worry about where you're parking your car. Or wherever the TSA at the airport. You know, you don't have to worry about any of that. You just go out and you sail. And you go from place to place. You know, that's a wonderful thing. I think I'll go do that right now. So, till next time, fair winds to your sails, keep your weather eye open, and your powder dry.